Hi everyone, I'm Ben Seiler. I work here at Microsoft on IoT Security. And with me is Arjman, who's one of our engineering leads on IoT Security. So Arjman, thanks for being with me today. We have a lot of audience who really understand information security. You know, they're pretty comfortable with it, but IoT security brings its own challenges and is relatively new. So starting from a knowledge basis of information security, what should we think about as we move to IoT security?
So IoT security is different and I would say very important because it now goes all the way to your devices. So right. It cannot just stay only in the cloud or in your applications which are running in the cloud or even on-prem. Now you're connecting devices which might be out there, and these devices are heterogeneous. So they could be big, small, many operating systems, many different operating systems. They could actually have no operating system on them as well. But they're all connected. And they're all doing something important. Either they're pulling out data from that environment and sending it to that application in the cloud, or they're actuating something, they're controlling something. And hence, making sure that your end-to-end IoT security is good is extremely important, and it goes beyond what we are used to doing with IT security.
Okay, so there's a lot of things that you highlighted there from the devices themselves, and then sometimes the devices, you know, they find themselves in interesting environments as well where you can't trust the environment. What should people think about when they're thinking about potentially hostile networks or environments?
Yeah, so one, of course, is because of the heterogeneity of all these devices. Also, the heterogeneity in the sense that there are some new devices and some old devices. And so the devices might not be designed to be secure if they're very old ones. So we need to think about all of these together. We need to think about how do we bring in these devices and what are the security properties of each of these devices and how do these security properties work with the application. And then, of course, there are many things that we can provide. We have features in the cloud which allow you to control your devices. We also have things like SDKs. We have a product called Azure Sphere and so on. So we have a lot of these things that we have built in and we have thought about which give you security, end-to-end security.
Yeah, that makes sense. And one of the things that I actually really enjoy about Microsoft IoT is that there are a lot of patterns and abstractions that we provide because, you know, there's a lot of complication going on with all these different things that you've mentioned. So it's hard for people to take it all at once. But if they can rely on patterns, that makes it a little bit easier. So can you talk through what some of the core patterns or abstractions are that we provide that people can take advantage of?
Yeah. So, of course, we have the cloud. Which allows you to secure whatever you're running there inherently. So we provide all the infrastructure which is secure. You can run an application there and we give you a secure infrastructure to run that application in the cloud. So that's one pattern, the cloud pattern. Then we have patterns on the devices. On the device side, we have the SDKs, the Azure IoT device SDKs, which are open sourced on GitHub. You include those in your devices when you're putting those together. And these devices and the SDK on top of it provides you with an abstraction on top of your device itself. It could also be the security properties of the device. For example, do you have the hardware-based root of trust? And the SDK provides you with an abstraction on the device. Then another one is the IoT Edge, Azure IoT Edge, which is another product that we have from Microsoft, which allows you to do these abstractions together. So it can allow you to bring cloud services to Edge devices, as well as to have the local abstractions, which are because of the SDKs. So all of these different abstractions from the SDK to IoT Edge to the cloud services get together and provide you with a way to think about security at a higher level, and not have to worry about the down below, the how do I actually go and access hardware and so on. That's all covered in these abstractions.
Yeah, that's great. As we get down below those abstractions, start thinking about the details of IoT security, IoT devices always come up. You know, that's what people think of when they think of IoT. So what do you need to create or to have an secure IoT device?
Yeah. So, of course, that's a challenge, as we just described, heterogeneity, so many different kinds of devices. And so a couple of years back, we all stepped back at Microsoft and we started thinking about what are the properties of a highly secure device. We came up with a set of principles and properties. We call them the 7 properties of highly secure devices. Now, these properties have been known to the security community for a long time. But what we did there was we put them together in the world of IoT. of that IoT device. And some of them, for example, a device needs to have a hardware-based root of trust, mm-hmm. right, in which you are securing your secrets and your keys and your certificates. So that's one property. Another property is the device should be updatable, that we should be able to go and securely update the device so that we are always assured that the device is in a good state. And similarly, there are seven properties. So we came up with these seven properties. We looked around and we said, okay, now putting that white paper, which is and we'll provide you with a URL, but mm-hmm. Putting them out was not sufficient. We also said that we need to actually have a device which incorporates all these seven properties. And so we have Azure Sphere, which is an MCU class device, which essentially has all these seven properties built into the design of Azure Sphere. And then you can take Azure Sphere and then deploy. And we take care of monitoring it, updating it, and we provide you with all the controls, security controls that you need for that one device, mm-hmm. so that you are assured that that device is secure and it conforms to all these seven properties.
Makes sense. So we talk a lot about devices because, you know, that's what everybody always notices about IoT. But when you take a device and you start slurping up the data from the device into the cloud, all of a sudden your cloud now is a very attractive target for attackers as well. So could you show us a little bit about what we do to secure on the cloud side all of the devices in the IoT infrastructure?
Yes. So over here I have IoT Hub, which is really our service in the cloud. It's called Azure IoT Hub. That service essentially allows you to connect lots of devices to the cloud. And when you do that, you can actually get all the data into the cloud and run some applications on top of the data. You can analyze it, you can visualize it, you can store it, do whatever, right? Now, IoT Hub then becomes the center, the place where all of this activity is happening. It knows your devices, it knows where the data is going. So to protect IoT Hub is extremely important. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to show you two things here. One, of course, is how do you protect IoT Hub and what are the different things you could do with IoT Hub so that you can actually control who has access to that IoT Hub instance. And over here, I'm showing you the access control mechanism, the blades that allow you to do that. You can actually, it's all based on role-based access control, which happens to be one of the industry standards these days. RBAC, which is role-based access control, allows you to do role assignments, user assignments. So essentially, you can actually define what a user is supposed to do, assign the user to a certain task based on principle of least privileges. Mm-hmm. And now that user can only do those things. And so over here, you can define that. You can define who are the administrators, who can actually administer it, your solution in the cloud. And with this, you can actually control and you can protect the cloud side of your application. So that's one part of what we have. Now, another thing that I'll show you is how do you actually protect your devices from doing bad things to the cloud? So for which we have what we call the shared access policies. Now, these shared access policies go on to devices and could be anywhere. It could be also a service. But in those policies, you define what that shared access policy would do or what that device would do. Mm-hmm. For example, I'm going to go into this device policy. And this is a built-in policy. You can add to it and change it. You can also add your own policy here, but these are the default policies we ship with. This device, if it has this policy, cannot read the registry, which is your identity, the place where you store all your identity. It cannot write to it. It cannot do service connects directly, only through IoT Hub. It is only used for device connect. You can actually change that, and now you have a new policy. But the default policy only allows this device to connect to IoT Hub and nothing more. So that actually protects your rest of the application, the rest of the cloud, and the device itself. You can also disable this device whenever you want. Mm-hmm. And all of this portal that I'm showing you is based on our Azure portal. And there are APIs supporting all of this and SDKs. So you can actually take this and include it in your own enterprise management that you already have. So this functionality is what we think you can use, but you can actually use these APIs any way you like.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you, Arjmand. And thanks to all of you for watching this video. We have many more videos on Azure security as well as a few more on IoT, so please take a look.